Fuck that. All right, we gonna lighten this shit up a little bit. This segment is called Embarrassing Stories. It's getting embarrassing here. So here I go. I'm gonna go first. So dog, check this out. Get up on the mic a little bit.
Yeah, man, get your talk, man. Get your talk, homie.
Get my talk on real quick.
Here it is. Let me lean back a little bit so I can hear this. All right, with my ears, you know.
So dig this, dog. Like, I'm like 8 years old, right? You know what I mean? Like, and I'm at this pool, and I'm just like, it's an indoor pool. The pool is indoors. You know what I mean? I'm with somebody who was like a cousin at the time. And, you know, I can't swim worth a damn. This ain't no secret. I can't swim worth a damn.
We don't never need to go to the Bahamas, then.
We don't never need to go to the Bahamas. I need to be on the sand if I'm in the Bahamas.
Nah.
I don't want to be in the water. I would be that grown ass man in the water with a flotation device.
Yeah, that's the easier solution, man. Just,
I mean, yeah.
You need to go soak up some of that water, man.
But what if I fail at swimming? You know what I mean? Like, you can do that. People have done that. There's a track record and obituaries dedicated to people who failed at swimming. No offense to those people. Please rest in peace. But that's basically.
What do you mean fail at swimming? You mean drowning?
That is essentially the definition of failing at swimming is drowning.
No, that means you don't know how to swim.
So, is it not failing at swimming?
I mean, if you got to put it in a grade perspective, then yes, that is not passing swimming. That is.
It's not passing swimming. You definitely did not excel at swimming. No offense.
You never learned.
I mean, there's different situations. You know, there's different situations. You know.
Anyway, I don't know.
Okay. So anyway, back to my story. Back to it. We get right back on it. So like, I'm basically like just jumping around in the 3 feet. You know what I mean? Because I'm like 5'8" or some shit like that. So I'm like just bouncing around.
Wait. Yeah,
I was tall as fuck when I was 8 years old.
5'8"?
Yeah, I was 5'8". I was 5'8".
So you the same height that you was when you was...
I ain't 5'8", girl.
5'8"?
Okay, look.
Eight?
Don't listen to her. This might be edited out because she's telling lies.
5'8". That's how tall you are now, ain't it?
No, I'm like 5'10", yo.
Okay.
Yeah, those two inches matter.
Ah. Right?
They matter.
Yeah,
sorry,
the 2 inches matter a hell of a lot. Man. Wow.
No.
You're taking away from my story.
But you said 5'8" at 8 years old.
Yeah, that's what was happening. There was one summer I didn't get any sleep, and I'm not going to get into it.
Yeah, that's
personal. It's personal. I didn't get no sleep one summer at a crucial summer. A very crucial. Right before middle school, you're supposed to get a lot of sleep. You get them growth spurts, and you grow. But anyway... So like I'm jumping around in 3 feet, you know what I mean, just doing my thing. So then this girl comes up to me, right? And she looks at me and she says, "Are you hard?"
Whoa.
She just straight up approached you. In your 8-year-old form, standing at 5'8", she's gonna ask you, "Are you hard?"
In my 5'8" stature.
Wow.
At 8 years old.
I'm 8 years old now.
Son is not right about that. He wasn't 8 years old.
I'm jumping around in that pool. 8 years old.
He wasn't 8.
I was 8 years old.
There's no way.
I was only 8 years old.
Because then that means that you slept that whole entire summer and more. You know that, right?
Okay, but let me get to the funny part.
That was the funny part.
Okay, look. No, that's not the funny part. All right, don't listen to that. That's not the funny. So listen, like real talk. So like I'm like, I don't know what that means at the age of 8 when you ask me am I hard. I'm thinking like on some gangster shit. So I'm just like, yeah, I'm hard, man. Hell yeah, I'm hard. Hardest motherfucker in here.
Nice comeback. Nice comeback.
Her face looked so fucked up when I said that shit. Like, because she was older than me, obviously. You know what I mean? Me being 5'8", at 8 years old, it's just hard to confuse. You know, you don't think I'm 8 years old being 5'8", at 8.
But you said you didn't have a growth spurt.
No, I had a growth spurt going on then. It was happening right then. It was going on then.
But you said you didn't get no sleep that whole summer.
No, it was the summer after that. To where I just stopped growing at about 5'9", 5'10".
Okay.
Yeah, you know, I got up at 5'10", and it was like, boom. That's it. You won't make the 6 feet.
But I just can't see an 8-year-old at 5'8".
Well, that's what was happening. You could go look at that picture at Robert Shaw and see I was taller than most everybody up in there. Nah. And it wasn't because of the positioning. That was everybody's height.
That was 5'8"? That was 5'8".
Matter of fact, I'm gonna post a picture of it right up in here to show a lot of y'all. I don't know if I will. You might see a picture. I don't know.
You should show the picture.
You might see the picture.
But that was 5'8". That was 5'8" in that picture.
All right, so B, what about your stuff?
You stood your ground there, homie. Commend you, dog. You stood your ground, homie, you know?
I appreciate you, dog.
That's how you respond to any random girl asking you something as an 8-year-old standing 5'8". That's how you talk with your 5'8"-ness, all right? That's how you talk, all right? Good. My man.
I totally get disrespected.
Yeah.
I don't get my question answered.
No, man. It was 5'8", man. That's,
it wasn't 5'8".
See, I knew you was going to say that. We try to move on to B's and B's.
Okay.
That's it. It's my embarrassing story. Okay. You know what? I can remember back in my young Atlanta days when I was living on Buford Highway, man. Back in what is now the territory of the Amigos, you know, that's their territory now. They doing their thing out there, man. But when I was living there, it was a nice multicultural, you know, background out there, man. But, I remember one day, I must have been like maybe 5 or 6, and for some apparent reason, dog, I decided to go out on the balcony, and I ended up dropping one of my action figures. I remember, it was my Magneto action figure. God damn it, Magneto. He slipped through my hands, fell through the rail on the balcony. So I try to grab Magneto, and I stick my arm out the balcony first, and then my head. Oh, I try to pull back.
Oh my God, this is going.
My little 5-year-old ass is stuck on that damn balcony, like, ah.
This is where Dante inserts that episode of Martin. It's not that golden shit, that golden headboard shit. This is how Brennan looks.
This is a clip she said I should insert only because I didn't agree with this, but I'm doing it right here. Here's the clip. Boom.
Come on, baby. Let's ride a new bed back to Africa, baby. Hot damn. Hello? Can I speak to 911? Yeah, this is emergency. All right, I'll hold. Damn.
Boy, hurry up!
Okay, look, baby, don't panic. I got 911 on the line. Hey, look here. 911, my woman, she's stuck in bed. Well, what happened, right? We brought this new bed, right? So we got the bouncing doing this old freaky diggy type thing. And then, damn. Just look, use your imagination, all right?
Boy,
yeah.
What
yeah.
Are they-
Our baby, they laughing at us, Gina.
I'm sorry, would you please help me? I can't get out.
I'm coming, baby. I'm coming. Look, turn sideways. Turn sideways, Gina.
Ow!
Pivot, Jay.
I can't. Wait, no, Gina, they're laughing.
right? And Gina, look, I'm suing the hell out of that bed company, Gina.
Mike, you gotta get me out of this thing. You gotta get me out of this thing, Mike. I gotta get to work. I can't miss this meeting.
Okay, all right, now look. Gina, look. Now look. Let's not lose our head on this one, okay? Baby, we just gotta think our way out of this, okay?
Come on. Okay, Mark, could you please hurry up? Because I think my head is swelling.
Damn, baby, I didn't think your head could get no bigger.
Okay. Ain't doing no stone with me, I swear. Right. This is very serious.
Okay. It's because it's the perfect, you can actually see what he means.
I mean, like, my Magneto was gone. I was heartbroken because it's a bush. As a kid, you don't mess around and go in bushes. I don't know what the hell's in there. A damn troll, an ant. You just don't mess around. So Magneto's gone. My head's stuck. I'm trying to get out. I'm like, Ma, I can't even get the full sentence. I'm like, Ma. She hears me. She comes out to the balcony. She's like, oh, my God. You know, it's that point. I'm just sitting there. She calls my dad. He's at work, you know. Oh, my God. He has to leave work, finally get there, but... right before he gets there, I think the fire department comes and they see, and all of them get me out, and I'm like, "Yeah, man, all over a damn Magneto." It was a cool action figure, man. But
action figures used to go in.
It's just gone, bro. You know, that's my embarrassing story, man.
So I feel you, man. I feel you, dog.
I've never got my head stuck since then. I will say that. Mm-hmm. I took that as a lesson. Lesson learned.
Lesson learned.
Don't go chasing after toys.
Don't go chasing out the toys that are apparently out of reach. They're out of reach for a reason.
Yeah.
Magneto was definitely probably one of the coolest actors. Did the helmet come off?
The helmet came off.
Oh, the helmet came off on the Magneto. I would have went after that shit, too.
He had the cape.
He had the cape?
Had the cape, bro.
Was it like a plastic or flowing cape?
Oh, it was flowing, though.
Oh.
Flowing. You know, like when I used to have my little wrestling matches, would always be the champion, bro.
Oh shit.
Yeah, man.
Let me tell you something about this nigga right here. This nigga used to have all the action figures with the wrestling fucking ring. And he used to be making them niggas have all kinds of matches, and it would be I'd actually watch the shit. Yeah. It's pretty good. Some good creative shit going on.
Thanks, man. I was in the staging back then, you know, just put on a good show, man. Yeah.
Yeah. That was not it. I bet y'all thought that was gonna be a diss, yeah. Like, nah. It's some amazing shit. We was doing some creative shit at a simple time. That's how that works. I mean, it's not surprising.
For the iPhones and the iPads and all the gizmos and gadgets. You know, less was more to us, man.
There you go. Less is more. These kids running around with all these toys, they killing each other with and shit. Sorry, killing each other with these toys. Anyway, that was a good story, man. I do appreciate you for sharing the embarrassing moment.
Mine is truly embarrassing. I don't know.
Okay, well, we might have to say, are you going or not?
I don't know.
Okay. All right, it looks like that is it for the embarrassing stories for the moment.